What can you do if you have chronic pain? What's worse than living with chronic pain? Not much. We know that chronic pain affects all parts of someone's life: their mood, their ability to move or have social engagements, their ability to laugh and enjoy life, their ability to work and play. Is this a hopeless situation? Some people would say so. There has been an understanding in the medical community for the past few decades that chronic pain is not fixable, that anyone with chronic pain just has to live with it and just try to cope the best that they can. This is a very depressing thought, and actually, getting this news from a doctor just makes the whole situation worse. But is it true that chronic pain is always chronic? That is, just goes on forever and ever? Is this always correct? Or is this just an opinion? We know that there are some people who have such severe physical disorders that they really do have to simply cope as well as they can. For example, if someone has severe lung disease, they will have to live with less pulmonary function and less ability to exercise. But of course, they would want to get good medical treatment to improve what lung function they do have. And of course, they want to do as much exercise as possible in order to build up their stamina and improve their quality of life. In the case of pain, if the pain is caused by a severe medical problem, such as cancer that has spread to bones, medical treatment can help, but it may not get rid of the pain completely. So the person may have to manage with that pain using medications. The same is true if there is severe arthritis of a joint. There are a lot of medical conditions that can cause chronic pain, but there are also a lot of people who have chronic pain and doctors just can't find the cause. Which leads us to a very interesting question. Can chronic pain be caused by the brain? Most doctors don't think of the brain as a primary cause of chronic pain, but it turns out that it is probably very common. Yes, you might be surprised to hear this, so listen on. We know that the brain's danger signal machinery can cause pain even in the absence of a physical injury, especially when there is a stressful situation that is going on. And two things can happen to cause that pain to become chronic. First, the stressful situation can just go on and on and on, causing the brain's danger signal circuits to keep sending messages of danger in the form of pain, such as headaches, back pain, or abdominal pain. Secondly, once pain starts, it's pretty hard not to pay attention to it. The normal response to pain is to react to it, and to react with fear and worry. That's a good response to have if the pain is caused by a physical problem that needs quick attention, such as if there's a fracture or a heart attack. But if the pain is actually due to a stressful situation activating danger signals, that fear and worry response can actually make the pain worse. Our response sends a message to the brain that, yes, there's a problem, and this promotes the brain to actually create more pain. Over time, this can create a vicious cycle that can lead to chronic pain. When the pain goes on for more than 3 to 6 months, we call it chronic pain. In chronic pain, the brain actually learns pain in just the same way that our brains learn to do other activities, such as play a guitar, or ride a bike, or do a flip. Our brains learn by developing neural circuits. Neural circuits are connections of brain cells that are wired together so that we can do something without having to think about it or even try very hard. Once you can ride a bike, it's easy. Your brain does most of the work for you. Unfortunately, this same process can occur with chronic pain. The brain circuits learn pain and keep generating that pain. This occurs in the subconscious brain without our even being aware of it. Often, the brain will develop a linkage or an association so that certain things trigger the pain to occur. Some of these triggers appear to be physical. For example, someone may get a headache when they see a bright light or hear a loud sound. Someone may get face pain when they feel a cool breeze. Someone may get stomach pain if they eat a certain food, or back pain if they bend over. But the stimulus, the cool breeze, spicy food, or bending over, may not actually be causing any pain. Instead, the stimulus is a trigger, activating the brain's neural circuitry to turn on the pain. This is a well-known phenomenon. The Russian scientist, Pavlov, rang a buzzer and gave his dogs food at the same time. Pretty soon, the dogs began to salivate when they heard the buzzer, even if there was no food there. This is called a conditioned response, and all people can develop these over time. If the stimulus and response continues for long enough, it becomes chronic. So what can we do about chronic pain? Step 1. First, we can figure out if the pain is due to a medical problem or a neural circuit problem. This may sound a bit surprising, but most people with chronic pain do not have a physical injury or a structural problem causing the pain. What? Yes, it's true. People with chronic headaches, chronic abdominal or pelvic pain, or chronic widespread pain, also called fibromyalgia, often do not have a structural disorder. Some people with severe arthritis in the knees, hips, or shoulders do have structural problems, of course. But most people with back pain do not have a clearly identifiable injury. They may have an abnormal MRI scan. They might have abnormal labs. But the right doctor will often help you understand that the findings of degenerative disease on an MRI scan is in fact a normal finding and not the primary cause of your pain. Step 2. Educate yourself about neural circuit pain and the mind-body connection. There are some websites, lectures, and books available so you can learn more. The more you know, the easier it will be to get better. This will provide you with hope. Hope that you can get better. The treatment of neural circuit pain is designed to eliminate pain, not merely to help you cope with it. Step 3. Learn how to turn off the danger signal in the brain. The danger signal in the brain is being activated out of fear. The biggest fears are often fears of pain itself and fears of the triggers to pain. So you need to learn how to reduce those fears. You can calm your brain by telling your brain that everything is okay. Thank you, brain, for your concern. But my body is fine, and you can relax. You don't need to protect me so much now. You can breathe and meditate to calm the brain. And you can observe sensations you feel without fear, separating yourself from them and not letting them bother you as much. You can begin to reverse the triggers by smiling at them instead of worrying about them. For example, when you encounter lights, sounds, weather changes, bending forward, walking, you can smile and go forward with joy, knowing that you are going to get better, gradually, over time. This is like when your child falls down. They immediately look at you to see if they should cry or not, based upon your reaction. The subconscious brain is the same way. It is looking at your reaction to pain to see if it should keep creating pain or calm down. Relax and turn off the pain over time. When you respond to pain with the knowledge that you are not damaged and that you will get better, and when you respond with calm and a smile, these are very powerful ways to retrain your brain and reprogram the neural circuits that are causing pain. Step 4. Address any important stressful situations and emotional issues in your life. Reflect on what your brain might be telling you. Do you need to stand up for yourself sometimes? Do you need to take better care of yourself or take more time for yourself? Do you need to set boundaries with a neighbor? Do you need to take some action in your life that you've been postponing? Write about some of the issues in your life that may have bothered you for a long time. This can help to free your mind from past or current stressful situations. Do some things for yourself and for others. Be more active physically. Engage in social activities. Don't talk about your pain, but live your life with joy. In conclusion, doing all of these things will train your brain out of pain and put you and your brain on much better terms. You and your brain will be friends again, happy again.